Good afternoon and happy St. Patrick's Day. We are honored to have you here for our Lenten Friday recitals, both in person and live stream. We begin our time together with noonday prayer, which can be found in the red Book of Common Prayer, beginning on page 103. O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Continuing on page 104, we'll read Psalm 121 responsively by whole verse. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come?
My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved, and he who watches over you will not fall asleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand.
So that the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night.
The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe.
The Lord shall watch over you going out
from the forevermore. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from 2 Corinthians. If anyone is in Christ, they are a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. All this is from God, who through Christ reconciled us to himself and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. I'll read for us a short bio on Patrick. Patrick was born into a Christian family somewhere on the northwest coast of Britain around 390. His grandfather had been a Christian priest and his father, Calpurnius, a deacon. Calpurnius was an important official in the late Roman imperial government of Britain. When Patrick was about 16, he was captured by a band of Irish slave raiders. He was carried off to Ireland and forced to serve as a shepherd. When he was about 21, he escaped and returned to Britain, where he was educated as a Christian. He tells us that he was ordained as both priest and bishop, although no particulars is known as his at this time. A vision then called him to return to Ireland, and he did so in around the year 431. Tradition holds that Patrick landed not far from the place of his earlier captivity, near what is known as Downpatrick. He then began a remarkable process of missionary conversion throughout the country that continued until his death, probably in 461. He made his appeal to the local kings and through them to their tribes, Christianizing the old pagan region as he went. Patrick erected Christian churches over sites already regarded as sacred and crosses carved on old Druidic pillars, and put sacred wells and springs under the protection of the Christian saints. Many legends of Patrick's Irish missionary travels possess substances of truth, especially those retelling his conversion of three major Irish high kings. Two works are attributed to Patrick, an autobiographical confession in which he tells us, among other things, that he was criticized by his contemporaries for a lack of learning, and a letter to Corotus, a British chieftain. The Laurissa of St. Patrick's breastplate, I bind unto myself today, was probably not written by him, dating most probably from the 8th century rather than the 5th. But it does express his faith and zeal. Patrick, bishop and missionary. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, in your providence, you chose your servant Patrick to be the apostle to the Irish people, to bring those who were wandering in darkness and error to the true light and knowledge of you. Grant us so to walk in that way, that we may come at last to the light of everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I invite you now to lift up the names of those on your hearts or in your minds who you would like us to remember, either silently or aloud. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign now and forever. Let us bless the Lord.
concert at 7 with a singer and a guitar player and all lots of Irish music, so and for a good cause. We hope to see you tomorrow if you can. Thank you so much for coming.